This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Silicon is a chemical element with symbol C and atomic number 14, a hard and brittle crystalline solid with a blue-gray metallic luster. It is a tetravalent metalloid. It is a member of group 14 in the periodic table, along with carbon above it and germanium, tin, lead, and fluorovium below it. Is rather unreactive, though less so than germanium, and has great chemical affinity for oxygen. As such, it was first prepared and characterized in pure form only in 1823 by Johns Jakob Berzelius. Silicon is the 8th most common element in the universe by mass, but very rarely occurs as the pure element in the Earth's crust. It is most widely distributed in dusts, sands, planetoids, and planets as various forms of silicon dioxide silica or silicates. Over 90% of the Earth's crust is composed of silicate minerals, making silicon the second most abundant element in the Earth's crust, about 28% by mass after oxygen. Most silicon is used commercially without being separated, and often with little processing of the natural minerals. Such use includes industrial construction with clays, silica sand, and stone silicate is used in Portland cement for mortar and stucco, and mixed with silica sand and gravel to make concrete for walkways, foundations, and roads. Silicates are used in whiteware ceramics such as porcelain, and in traditional quartz-based soda-lime glass and many other specialty glasses. Silicon compounds such as silicon carbide are used as abrasives and components of high-strength ceramics. Elemental silicon also has a large impact on the modern world economy. Most free silicon is used in the steel refining, aluminium casting, and fine chemical industries, often to make fumed silica even more visibly. The relatively small portion of very highly purified silicon used in semiconductor electronics. For production, 41 alloys, 42 metallurgical grade, 43 polysilicon, 431 Siemens process and alternatives, 44 electronic grade, 441 early purification techniques, 45 occupational safety and health, 5 compounds, 6 applications, 61 compounds, 62 alloys, 63 electronics, 64 mechanical watches, 7 biological role, 8 see also, 9 references, 10 bibliography. 11 External links. Characteristics. Physical silicon crystallizes in a diamond cubic crystal structure. Further information. Monocrystalline silicon. Silicon is a solid at room temperature, with a melting point of 1414. The number of free charge carriers increases with temperature. The electrical resistance of single crystal silicon significantly changes under the application of mechanical stress due to the piezoresistive effect. Chemical silicon powder. Silicon is a metalloid, readily donating or sharing its 4 outer electrons, and it typically forms 4 bonds like carbon. Its 4 bonding electrons enable it to combine with many other elements or compounds to form a wide range of compounds. Unlike carbon, it can accept additional electrons and form 5 or 6 bonds in a sometimes more labile silicate form. Tetravalent silicon is relatively inert. It reacts with halogens and dilute alkalis, but most acids except some hyper-reactive combinations of nitric acid and hydrofluoric acid have no effect on it. Isotopes. Main article, isotopes of silicon. Naturally occurring silicon is composed of 3 stable isotopes, 28C9223%, 29C467%, and 30C310%, with 28C being the most abundant out of these. Only 29C is of use in NMR and EPR spectroscopy, as it is the only one with a nuclear spin. I equals 1/2. 20 radioisotopes have been characterized, with the most stable being 32C with a half-life of 170 years, and 31C with a half-life of 1,573 minutes. All of the remaining radioactive isotopes have half-lives that are less than 7 seconds, and the majority of these have half-lives that are less than 1/10 of a second. Silicon does not have any known nuclear isomers. 32C undergoes low-energy beta decay to 32P and then stable 32S. 31C may be produced by the neutron activation of natural silicon and is thus useful for quantitative analysis. The isotopes of silicon range in mass number from 22 to 44. The most common decay mode of the isotopes with mass numbers lower than the 3 stable isotopes is inverse beta decay, primarily forming aluminium isotopes. 13 protons as decay products. The most common decay mode for the heavier unstable isotopes is beta decay, primarily forming phosphorus isotopes. 15 protons as decay products. History. Attention was first drawn to silica as the possible oxide of a fundamental fundamental chemical element by Antoine Lavoisier, in 1787 after an attempt to isolate silicon in 1808, Sir Humphrey Davy proposed the name silicium for silicon, from the Latin silex, silicis for flint, and adding the ium ending because he believed it was a metal in 1811. Gay Lussac and Thénard are thought to have prepared impure amorphous silicon through the heating of recently isolated potassium metal with silicon tetrafluoride, but they did not purify and characterize the product, nor identify it as a new element. Silicon was given its present name in 1817 by Scottish chemist Thomas Thomson. He retained part of Davy's name but added on because he believed that silicon was a nonmetal similar to boron and carbon in 1823. Berzelius prepared amorphous silicon using approximately the same method as Gay Lussac, potassium metal and potassium fluorosilicate, but purifying the product to a brown powder by repeatedly washing it as a result. He is usually given credit for the element's discovery. Silicon in its more common crystalline form was not prepared until 31 years later, by Deville, by electrolyzing a mixture of sodium chloride and aluminium chloride containing approximately 10% silicon. He was able to obtain a slightly impure allotrope of silicon in 1854. Later, more cost-effective methods have been developed to isolate several allotrope forms, the most recent being silicene. Because silicon is an important element in high-technology semiconductor devices, many places in the world bear its name. For example, Santa Clara Valley in California acquired the nickname Silicon Valley since the element is the base material used in the semiconductor industry located there. Other locations have been nicknamed for similar reasons, including Silicon Forest in Oregon, Silicon Hills in Austin, Texas, Silicon Slopes in Salt Lake City, Utah, Silicon Saxony in Germany, Silicon Valley in India, Silicon Border in Mexicali, Mexico, Silicon Fen in Cambridge, England, Silicon Roundabout in London, Silicon Glen in Scotland, and Silicon Gorge in Bristol, England. Occurrence quartz crystal cluster from Tibet. The naturally occurring mineral is a network solid with the formula silicon oxide. See also, silicate minerals measured by mass. Silicon makes up 277% of the Earth's crust and is the second most abundant element in the crust, with only oxygen having a greater abundance. Silicon is usually found in the form of complex silicate minerals, and less often as silicon dioxide. Silica, a major component of common sand. Pure silicon crystals are very rarely found in nature, but notable exceptions are crystals as large as to 0.3. Rocky planetesimals that formed the terrestrial planets here. The reduced silicate mineral matrix entrapped the metals reactive enough to be oxidized. Aluminium, calcium, sodium, potassium and magnesium after loss of volatile gases, as well as carbon and sulfur by reaction with hydrogen. This silicate mixture of elements formed most of the Earth's crust. These silicates were of relatively lower density than iron, nickel, and other metals non-reactive to oxygen, and a residuum of uncombined metallic iron and nickel sank to the planet's core, leaving a thick mantle of mostly of magnesium and iron silicates between core and crust. These are thought to be mostly silicate perovskites, followed in abundance by the magnesium, iron oxide ferropericlase. Examples of silicate minerals in the crust include those in the pyroxene, amphibole, mica, and feldspar groups. These minerals occur in clay and various types of rock such as granite and sandstone in the crust. Very pure silica occurs in different crystalline forms of quartz and opal. The crystals have the empirical formula of silicon dioxide, but do not consist of discrete silicon dioxide molecules in the manner of solid carbon dioxide. Rather, silica is structurally a network solid consisting of silicon and oxygen in three-dimensional crystals, like diamond. Less pure silica forms the natural glass obsidian. Biogenic silica occurs in the structure of diatoms, radiolaria and siliceous sponges. Silicon is also a principal component of many meteorites, and of tektites, a mineral of possibly lunar origin, or if Earth-derived, which has been subjected to unusual temperatures and pressures, possibly from meteorite strike production. Alloys: ferrosilicon alloy. Ferrosilicon, an iron-silicon alloy that contains varying ratios of elemental silicon and iron, accounts for about 80% of the world's production of elemental silicon, with China, the leading supplier of elemental silicon, providing 46 million tons or two-thirds of the world output of silicon, most of which is in the form of ferrosilicon. It is is followed by Russia 610,000 t, Norway 330,000 t, Brazil 240,000 t, and the United States 170,000 t. Ferrosilicon is primarily used by the iron and steel industry, see below, with primary use as alloying addition in iron or steel and for de-oxidation of steel in integrated steel plants. Aluminium silicon alloys called silumen alloys are heavily used in the aluminium alloy casting industry, where silicon is the single most important additive to aluminium to improve its casting properties, since cast aluminium is widely used in the automobile industry. This use of silicon is thus the single largest industrial use, about 55% of the total of metallurgical grade pure silicon, as this purified silicon is added to pure aluminium, whereas ferrosilicon is never purified before being added to steel. Metallurgical grade elemental silicon alloyed with significant quantities of other elements, usually up to 5%, is often referred to loosely as silicon metal. It makes up about 20% of the world total elemental silicon production, with less than 1-2% of total elemental silicon. 5-10% of metallurgical grade silicon ever purified to higher grades for use in electronics. Metallurgical grade silicon is commercially prepared by the reaction of high purity silica with wood, charcoal, and coal in an electric arc furnace using carbon electrodes at temperatures over 1,900.26 silicon oxide 3C2CO. As noted above, metallurgical grade silicon metal has its primary use in the aluminium casting industry to make aluminium silicon alloy parts. The remainder, about 45%, is used by the chemical industry, where it is primarily employed to make fumed silica, with the rest used in production of other fine chemicals such as silanes and some types of silicones. As of September 2008, metallurgical grade silicon costs about $145 per pound, $320 per kilogram, up from $0.77 per pound, $170 per kilogram in 2005. A polycrystalline silicon rod made by the Siemens process. Polysilicon. Main article: polycrystalline silicon. Today's purification processes involve the conversion of silicon into volatile liquids, such as trichlorosilane HSiCl3 and silicon tetrachloride silicon chloride, or into the gaseous silane silicon hydride. These compounds are then separated by a distillation and transformed into high-purity silicon, either by a redox reaction or by thermal decomposition. In the late 1950s, the American chemical company DuPont patented a method for the production of 9,999% pure silicon, using the metal zinc as a reductant to transform redistilled silicon tetrachloride into high-purity silicon by a vapor phase reaction at 900. Solidified and clogged lines, and was eventually abandoned in favor of more sophisticated processes. Schematic diagram of the traditional Siemens and the fluidized bed reactor purification process. Siemens process and alternatives. The best known technique is the so-called Siemens process. This technique does not require a reductant such as zinc, as it grows high-purity silicon crystallites directly on the surface of pre-existing pure silicon seed rods by a chemical decomposition that takes place when the gaseous trichlorosilane is blown over the rod's surface at 1150. Less setup and downtime. It uses about 10% of the electricity consumed by a conventional rod reactor in the established Siemens process, as it does not waste energy by placing heated gas and silicon in contact with cold surfaces in the FBR. Silane silicon hydride is injected into the reactor from below and forms a fluidized bed together with the silicon seed particles that are fed from above. The gaseous silane then decomposes and deposits silicon on the seed particles. When the particles have grown to larger granules, they eventually sink to the bottom of the reactor, where they are continuously withdrawn from the process. The FBR manufacturing technology outputs polysilicon at 6N to 9N, a purity still higher than the 5N to 6N of upgraded metallurgical silicon UMGC, a third technology used by the photovoltaic industry, that dispenses altogether with chemical purification, using metallurgical techniques instead. Currently, most silicon for the photovoltaic market is produced by the Siemens process, and only about 10% by the FBR technology, while UMGC accounts for about 2% by 2020. However, IHS Technology predicts that market shares for FBR technology and UMGC will grow to 167% and 54%, respectively. The company REC is one of the leading producers of silane and polysilicon using FBR technology. The three-step chemical reaction involves last step occurs inside the FB reactor, 1-3. by other companies as well. Electronic-grade monocrystalline silicon ingot grown by the Zakralsky process. Main article, monocrystalline silicon. The use of silicon in semiconductor devices demands a much greater purity than afforded by metallurgical-grade silicon. Very pure silicon. Early purification techniques. Early silicon purification techniques were based on the fact that if silicon is melted and re-solidified, the last parts of the mass to solidify contain most of the impurities. The earliest method of silicon purification, first described in 1919 and used on a limited basis to make radar components during World War II, involved crushing metallurgical grade silicon and then partially dissolving the silicon powder in an acid. When crushed, the silicon cracked so that the weaker impurity-rich region were on the outside of the resulting grains of silicon. As a result, the impurity-rich silicon was the first to be dissolved when treated with acid, leaving behind a more pure product in zone melting, also called zone refining. The first silicon purification method to be widely used industrially, rods of metallurgical-grade silicon are heated to melt at one end. Then, the heater is slowly moved down the length of the rod, keeping a small length of the rod molten as the silicon cools and re-solidifies behind it. Since most impurities tend to remain in the molten region rather than re-solidify, when the process is complete, most of the impurities in the rod will have been moved into the end that was the last to be melted. This end is then cut off and discarded, and the process repeated if a still higher purity is desired. Occupational safety and health. People can be exposed to silicon in the workplace by breathing it in, swallowing it, skin contact, and eye contact. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration OSHA has set the legal limit permissible exposure limit for silicon exposure in the workplace as 15 NH2N2, where N equals 228. Analogous to the alkanes, these are all readily hydrolyzed and are thermally unstable. Particularly the heavier members disilenes contain a silicon-silicon double bond analogous to the alkenes and are generally highly reactive, requiring large substituent groups to stabilize them. A disilene with a silicon-silicon triple bond was first isolated in 2004, although as the compound is nonlinear, the bonding is dissimilar to that in alkynes. Tetrahalides, 6-4, are formed with all the halogens. Silicon tetrachloride, for example, reacts with water. Unlike its carbon analog, carbon tetrachloride silicon dihalides are formed by the high-temperature reaction of tetrahalides and silicon. With a structure analogous to a carbon, they are reactive compounds. Silicon difluoride condenses to form a polymeric compound, SiF2N. Silicon dioxide silica is a high-melting solid with a number of crystal forms, the most familiar of which is the mineral quartz in crystalline quartz. Each silicon atom is surrounded by four oxygen atoms that bridge to other silicon atoms to form a three-dimensional lattice. See below for the vitreous or glass form of pure silica. Silica is soluble in water at high temperatures, forming a range of compounds called monosilicic acid. Silicon hydroxide under the right conditions. Monosilicic acid readily polymerizes to form more complex silicic acids, ranging from the simplest condensate, disilicic acid H6 silicon oxide, to linear, ribbon, layer and lattice structures which form the basis of the many silicate minerals and are called polysilicic acids. And silica can be fused directly into glass form, as so-called fused quartz, which contains no crystalline structure with oxides of other elements. The high temperature reaction of silicon dioxide can give a wide range of mixed glasses and glass-like network solids with various properties. Examples include soda lime glass, borosilicate glass and lead crystal glass. Silicon sulfide. Silicon sulfide is a polymeric solid. Unlike its carbon analog, the liquid CS2 silicon forms a nitride, silicon nitride, which is a ceramic silitranes, a group of tricyclic compounds containing five coordinate silicon, may have physiological properties. Many transition metal complexes containing a metal-silicon bond are now known, which include complexes containing SiHnX3-N ligands, 6-3 ligands, and SiOR3 ligands. Silicones are a large group of polymeric compounds with an COC backbone. An example is the silicone oil PDMS polydimethylsiloxane. These polymers can be cross-linked to produce resins and elastomers. Many organosilicon compounds are known which contain a silicon-carbon single bond. Many of these are based on a central tetrahedral silicon atom, and some are optically active when central chirality exists. Long-chain polymers containing a silicon backbone are known, such as polydimethylsiloxane SiM2N polycarboxylane, SiM2-2CH2N, with a backbone containing a repeating CCC unit, is a precursor in the production of silicon carbide fibers applications compounds building materials. Most silicon is used industrially without being separated into the element, and indeed often with comparatively little processing from natural occurrence. Over 90% of the Earth's crust is composed of silicate minerals, which are compounds of silicon and oxygen, often with metallic ions. When negatively charged silicate anions require cations to balance the charge, many of these have direct commercial uses, such as clays, silica sand, and most kinds of building stone. Thus, the vast majority of uses for silicon are as structural compounds, either as the silicate minerals or silica. Crude silicon dioxide silicates are used in making Portland cement made mostly of calcium silicates, which is used in building mortar and modern stucco, but more importantly, combined with silica sand, and gravel usually containing silicate minerals like granite, to make the concrete that is the basis of most of the very largest industrial building projects of the modern world. Ceramics and glass silica is used to make fire brick, a type of ceramic. Silicate minerals are also in whiteware. Ceramics, an important class of products usually containing various types of fired clay minerals. Natural aluminium phyllosilicates, an example is porcelain, which is based on the silicate mineral kaolinite. Traditional glass silica-based soda lime glass also functions in many of the same ways, and is also used for windows and containers. In addition, specialty silica-based glass fibers are used for optical fiber, as well as to produce fiberglass for structural support and glass wool for thermal insulation. Artificial silicon compounds. Very occasional elemental silicon is found in nature, and also naturally occurring compounds of silicon and carbon. Silicon carbide or nitrogen silicon nitride are found in stardust samples or meteorites in presolar grains. But the oxidizing conditions of the inner planets of the solar system make planetary silicon compounds found there mostly silicates and silica-free silicon, or compounds of silicon in which the element is covalently attached to hydrogen, boron, or elements other than oxygen, are mostly artificially produced. They are described below. Silicon compounds of more modern origin function as high-technology abrasives and new high-strength ceramics based upon silicon carbide. Silicon is a component of some superalloys alternating silicon-oxygen chains with hydrogen attached to the remaining silicon bonds form the ubiquitous silicon-based polymeric materials known as silicones. These compounds containing silicon-oxygen and occasionally silicon-carbon bonds have the capability to act as bonding intermediates between glass and organic compounds, and to form polymers with useful properties such as impermeability to water, flexibility and resistance to chemical attack. Silicones are often used in waterproofing treatments, molding compounds, mold release agents, mechanical seals, high-temperature greases and waxes, and caulking compounds. Silicone is also sometimes used in breast implants, contact lenses, explosives and pyrotechnics. Silly putty was originally made by adding boric acid to silicone oil alloys. Elemental silicon is added to molten cast iron as ferrosilicon or silicocalcium alloys to improve performance in casting thin sections and to prevent the formation of cementite where exposed to outside air. The presence of elemental silicon in molten iron acts as a sink for oxygen, so that the steel carbon content, which must be kept within narrow limits for each type of steel, can be more closely controlled. Ferrosilicon production and use is a monitor of the steel industry, and although this form of elemental silicon is grossly impure, it accounts for 80% of the world's use of free silicon. Silicon is an important constituent of electrical steel, modifying its resistivity and ferromagnetic properties. The properties of silicon can be used to modify alloys with metals other than iron. Metallurgical grade silicon is silicon of 95-99% purity. About 55% of the world consumption of metallurgical purity silicon goes for production of aluminium silicon alloys. Solumen alloys for aluminium part casts, mainly for use in the automotive industry. Silicon's importance in aluminium casting is that a significant high amount, 12% of silicon in aluminium, forms a eutectic mixture which solidifies with very little thermal contraction. This greatly reduces tearing and cracks formed from stress as casting alloys cool to solidity. Silicon also significantly improves the hardness and thus wear resistance of aluminium. Electronics main article, semiconductor device fabrication. Silicon wafer with mirror finish. Most elemental silicon produced remains as a ferrosilicon alloy, and only about 20% is refined to metallurgical grade purity. A total of 13 to 15 million metric ton per year, an estimated 15% of the world production of metallurgical grade silicon is further refined to semiconductor purity. However, the economic importance of this small very high purity fraction, especially the approximately 5% which is processed to monocrystalline silicon for integrated circuits, is disproportionately large. Large pure monocrystalline silicon is used to produce silicon wafers used in the semiconductor industry, in electronics, and in some high-cost and high-efficiency photovoltaic applications. Pure silicon is an intrinsic semiconductor, which means that unlike metals, it conducts electron holes and electrons released from atoms by heat. Silicon's electrical conductivity increases with higher temperatures. Pure silicon has too low a conductivity, i.e., too high a resistivity to be used as a circuit element in electronics. In practice, pure silicon is doped with small concentrations of certain other elements, which greatly increase its conductivity and adjust its electrical response by controlling the number and charge, positive or negative, of activated carriers. Such control is necessary for transistors, solar cells, semiconductor detectors, and other semiconductor devices used in the computer industry and other technical applications. In silicon photonics, silicon can be used as a continuous wave Raman laser medium to produce coherent light, though it is ineffective as an everyday light source. In common integrated circuits, a wafer of monocrystalline silicon serves as a mechanical support for the circuits, which are created by doping and insulated from each other by thin layers of silicon oxide, an insulator that is easily produced by exposing the element to oxygen under the proper conditions. Silicon has become the most popular material for both high-power semiconductors and integrated circuits because it can withstand the highest temperatures and greatest electrical activity without suffering avalanche breakdown. An electron avalanche is created when heat produces free electrons and holes, which in turn pass more current, which produces more heat. In addition, the insulating oxide of silicon is not soluble in water, which gives it an advantage over germanium, an element with similar properties which can also be used in semiconductor devices. In certain fabrication techniques, monocrystalline silicon is expensive to produce, and is usually justified only in production of integrated circuits, where tiny crystal imperfections can interfere with tiny circuit paths for other uses. Other types of pure silicon may be employed. These include hydrogenated amorphous silicon and upgraded metallurgical grade silicon UMGC, used in the production of low-cost, large-area electronics in applications such as liquid crystal displays, and of large-area, low-cost, thin-film solar cells. Such semiconductor grades of silicon are either slightly less pure or polycrystalline rather than monocrystalline, and are produced in comparable quantities as the monocrystalline silicon, 75,000 to 150,000 metric tons per year. The market for the lesser grade is growing more quickly than for monocrystalline silicon. By 2013, polycrystalline silicon production, used mostly in solar cells, was projected to reach 200,000 metric tons per year, while monocrystalline semiconductor grade silicon was expected to remain less than 50,000 tons per year. Mechanical watches. Since 2000, silicon has found a new use in mechanical watch movements. Several manufacturers of mechanical watch movements have incorporated silicon parts, mainly in the escapements and balance wheel regions. Silicon hair springs are becoming more common, as are silicon escapement wheels and forks. Silicon has several desirable properties when used in these contexts. It is thermally stable, shock resistant, and requires little to no lubrication. Ulysses Nardin pioneered these applications, with Omega, Breguet, Patek, Rolex, Cartier, and Damasco following. Most of these parts for watch movements are manufactured by deep reactive ion etching dry biological roll silica skeletons of radio Radiolaria in false color. Although silicon is readily available in the form of silicates, very few organisms use it directly. Diatoms, radiolaria, and siliceous sponges use biogenic silica as a structural material for skeletons. In more advanced plants, the silica phytoliths, opal phytoliths, are rigid microscopic bodies occurring in the cell. Some plants, for example rice, need silicon for their growth. There is some evidence that silicon is important to nail, hair, bone and skin health, for example in studies that show that premenopausal women with higher dietary silicon intake have higher bone density, and that silicon supplementation can increase bone volume and density in patients with osteoporosis. Silicon is needed for synthesis of elastin and collagen, of which the aorta contains the greatest quantity in the human body. Silicon is currently under consideration for elevation to the status of a plant beneficial substance by the Association of American Plant Food Control Officials AAPFCO. Silicon has been shown in university and field studies to improve plant cell wall strength and structural integrity, improve drought and frost resistance, decrease lodging potential, and boost the plant's natural pest and disease fighting systems. Silicon has also been shown to improve plant vigor and physiology by improving root mass and density, and increasing above-ground plant biomass and crop yields. See also amorphous silicon, black silicon, covalent superconductors, list of countries by silicon production, list of silicon producers, monocrystalline silicon, silicon nanowires, Sinos, polycrystalline silicon, printed silicon, electronics, silicon, Tombak, Silicon Valley, Silicon Wadi, transistor, books, view or order, collections of articles, silicon period, three elements, carbon group, chemical elements, sorted. Access related topics, chemistry portal, find out more on Wikipedia's sister projects, media from commons, definitions from Wiktionary, textbooks from Wikibooks, learning resources from Wikiversity, references Carat, conventional atomic weights, 2013 Commission on Isotopic Abundances and Atomic Weights, Carat, standard atomic weights, 2013 Commission on Isotopic Abundances and Atomic Weights, Carat, RAM, RS, et al., 1998, Fourier transform, emission spectroscopy of the A2DX2P transition of SiH and SiD, PDF J-mol SPECTR 190-341-352 PMID. Carat, Nielsen, Forrest H. 1984, Ultratrace Elements in Nutrition, Annual Review of Nutrition 421-41 doi, 101146, Anorevnu 0407018400321 PMID. Alumina, aluminium oxide, and silus silica, silicon dioxide, about these elements, Lavoisier speculates, we are probably only acquainted as yet with a part of the metallic substances existing in nature, as all those which have a stronger affinity to oxygen than carbon possesses, are incapable, hitherto, of being reduced to a metallic state, and consequently, being only presented to our observation under the form of oxides, are confounded with Earth's. It is extremely probable that barytes, which we have just now arranged with Earth's, is in this situation, for in many experiments it exhibits properties nearly approaching to those of metallic bodies. It is even possible that all the substances we call Earths may be only metallic oxides, irreducible by any hitherto known process. From page 218 of Lavoisier with Robert Kerr, Trans. Elements of Chemistry, 4th ed. Edinburgh, Scotland, William Creech, 1799. The original passage appears in Lavoisier, Traité élémentaire de chimie, Paris, France, Couchet, 1789. Volume 1, page 174. Carat, Davy, Humphrey, 1808, Electrochemical Researches, On the Decomposition of the Earths, with Observations on the Metals Obtained from the Alkaline Earths, and on the Amalgam Procured from Ammonia, Philosophical Transactions of the Royal Society of London, 98. Of Silicium, Aluminium, Zirconium, and Glucium, Carat, Gay, Lussac and Thenard, Recherches Physico-Chimiques, Paris, France, Dieterville, 1811, Volume 1, pages 313-314. Of silicon is detailed in the section titled Zersetzung der Flusspaths Kieseler durch Kalium, Decomposition of Silicate Fluoride by Potassium, pages 204-210. The above article was reprinted in French in Berzelius 1824, Decomposition du fluide de silice par le potassium. Decomposition of silica fluoride by potassium, Annales de chimie et de physique, 27. In both cases, pure silicon was produced, the silicon dissolved in the molten aluminium, but crystallized upon cooling, dissolving the crude aluminum in hydrochloric acid revealed flakes of crystallized silicon. C. Henri Saint Clair de Ville, 1854, Note sur deux procédés de préparation de l'aluminium et sur une nouvelle forme du silicium, Note on two procedures for the preparation of aluminium and on a new form of silicon, Comptes Rendus, 39. 544-544 doi, 101,038-375,544 A0 ISSN. Carat, Yasuda, Koji, Segusa, Kunio, Okabe, Toru H. 2010, Production of Solar-Grade Silicon by Halidothermic Reduction of Silicon Tetrachloride, Metallurgical and Materials Transactions B42-37, Bibcode, 2011 MMTB4237Y doi, 101,007 per seconds 11663-010944-0Y. Temperatures above its melting point. Journal of the Electrochemical Society 128:8-1712 doi:100149:12127716. Containing a silicon-silicon triple bond. Science 305:5691-1755-7 Bibcode 2004Sci305-1755S doi:101126 Science 1102209 PMID